Welcome to this episode of Happily Ever Hanks. As we experience some unexpected winter weather in this popular Arizona destination, what's our secret to dealing with sudden freezing temperatures without any preparation? You're about to see how experienced full-time RVers navigate these scenarios while still having fun. Now, get yourself a warm beverage and let's kick off the story.
Good evening, friends. We are currently on our way to Flagstaff. Kyle and Dexter are waiting in line for the discounted fuel, and I'm on my way to get some Dunkin' Donuts because I got a gift card. Excited to go to Flagstaff because it's such a cool area. It's been a while since we've ventured through there, but they've been getting a lot of snow recently. It's middle of March and Flagstaff is still experiencing a lot of winter, but we're gonna head there anyway and we're gonna see how much winter are we really going to endure. We got about 2 hour drive today after this. I'm just really looking forward to some adventures coming up, but coffee first.
Hey, can I do a black coffee
okay.
In a small vanilla bean colada?
Happy birthday!
Oh, thanks. It was given to me like months ago. So.
There you go.
Thank you. And we got my colada.
Yeah, that's the vanilla bean.
I know. Thank you.
Have a good day.
You too.
Holy cow, it's a long haul out here for just some coffees, but hey, they were free because I had a gift card. And you know what I just realized is I forgot a straw. Dang it. I made it so far, but I forgot your straw.
Oh no. That's
maybe
okay.
Maybe we have an extra one in our, you know, thing.
We'll figure it out.
We'll figure it out, okay.
All right, we gotta go. These truckers are like...
Okay. Okay.
Thanks, baby.
Just pull forward a second. I know we're breaking the rules by pulling forward.
Oh, we're not. You're allowed to do that. The trucker behind me has been flashing his lights for like 4 minutes straight, just like constantly flashing, but there was a truck in front of me. I couldn't go anywhere. But
really?
Maybe he just wants to put pressure on me. I'm not sure.
Well, you couldn't go anywhere, and yeah. They know how this works. Is it his first day as a trucker?
It might be. I'm going to go ask him right now. I'm just going to. Culotta, baby? Oh, thank you so much. I haven't had one of these in forever.
Everyone probably thinks the culotta was for me. I got a black coffee.
Ketchup. We got ketchup in here. We got napkins.
Oh, my goodness. Oh my gosh. Need to get it cleaned down here.
What is this? Do we live full time on the road, or what is this?
It's just as good as I remember it, too. Oh, man. I have a sweets addiction. I can't help it. Plus, I already have my cup of coffee today. Over 30 now, so I gotta watch how much caffeine intake I have every day.
Hey, cheers.
Cheers. Like stone, emotionless in this world of stories. Oh, like stone, I'm fixed in a framework that is moving beyond my control. Like stone, emotionless in this world of stories.
Meow if you're excited
to get off the road.
Okay.
Us too.
So you're still in shorts and a t-shirt. You still haven't grabbed a jacket.
I don't want to talk about it.
Oh my gosh, look at the snow everywhere. Oh. I mean, I guess it's still winter, technically.
Office. Okay, there it is.
I'm sorry, Dexter. I told you we'd go somewhere warmer, and we didn't do that.
Let's go see if we can check in real quick, even though we're blocking the road. I'll keep an eye on it. Come on. Let's go. Wow, it's cold out here. Why don't you bring me a jacket?
Don't even start. Okay, we'll be right back. Make good decisions.
Out in the park, be back at 10.
Oh, no. 10 minutes? I mean, we could do so much.
Well, we should figure it out quickly, because I'm cold.
Well, you're the one that decided to wear this.
Uh-oh, this truck's trying to do something.
There we go. How's the day going?
I changed the spot where you guys are going to be in.
Okay.
Just because the snow melted quite a bit, but it's really squishy there.
Yeah. Thank you.
I was prepared for us to shovel snow today.
It's nice and big and wide, and you can't.
Okay.
Just don't hit me or the fence.
Okay.
Definitely.
We can follow those rules.
All right. Let's do this.
Are you ready to camp in the snow? He's not excited.
Here we go.
So initially over the phone, she said, I have a site, but it's covered in snow. And I was like, I'll take it. But we got here and she said that they have a spot that's more clear for us. And I was like, okay,
how sweet,
sounds fine. But we're parked right next to her, which means we'll have to behave. Like Dexter runs around at night. And if you're parked next to us, you can hear the and every RV park I looked at the photos, it did not seem to be Starlink friendly. Every RV park in Flagstaff has tons of trees. Ooh, but maybe this one will be fine. Let's see. Nice.
That's us.
That's our site.
First your electrical box, Okay. Water, and then your sewer cleaner.
Sewer's there. Okay, sweet. Yeah. I love it.
I'm really excited to see how these winter storms, because they're coming in tonight, how it's gonna impact us.
Time of year, the Flagstaff weather is pretty bipolar. We've had snow already several times today.
It's been a while since we camped in winter weather, and it's gonna be like brushing off the pants with the dust kind of situation. I guess more than anything, Dexter, we're just gonna stay on top of making sure our pipes don't freeze.
Hey, can you hear me?
Hey, I can hear you. Let me just clear some snow out of the way for you. Don't you worry, I got this. Where I'm standing is where you wanna be center, like completely. Come to the right, just drop passenger side just a little bit. And then, and then follow through. Just push it that way a little and then straighten her out. Perfect, come back straight. Just keep coming. And stop right there. Look at you in your outfit in the snow.
Why, this is nothing. I bathe in the snow.
Get out of here.
Okay, that was really cool.
That was really cool. I was gonna say, as soon as the camera turns off, you're gonna be like, help me.
Help me, I'm chilly.
Is this gonna be enough room for the kitchen slide to make it its way out?
Well, I think so.
I think it'll be good.
Yeah.
This is cool that we get the winter camp.
Yeah.
Storms are coming in, get nice and toasty,
yeah.
Cozy. Yeah. Well, it's 2:00 in the afternoon, and it's just one of those days where what you see is what you get. I have not made it out of my sweatpants yet today, and quite frankly, I probably won't. Cold temperatures call for comfy vibes, so I'm just gonna keep that going all day while I'm editing. Today's a work day, so it's kind of in between travel days. We did make it to Flagstaff safely, and I'm really glad that Renee and I thought ahead of the game, where we left a day early to avoid all the inclement weather that we noticed yesterday. I looked out the window and it was downpouring so much snow. Is downpouring the right term? I don't know, it was just getting hammered here with snow. Glad we were not on the road at that time. The temperatures here have been not bad, except at night. It's been freezing every single night. So I've been having to unhook the fresh water hose, make sure our fresh tank is fully filled so that we can run off the water pump at night. I do have some good news, however. We have not had any frozen pipes yet. So knock on wood, we're gonna keep those vibes going. So yes, I am going to fill up the fresh tank right now. Make sure that we're good for this evening, because it's supposed to get, I think, 29 tonight. I'm actually kind of surprised that no one here is really skirted. I think everyone stays here on a long-term basis, but no one's skirted. Do you remember those Govee water sensors that we talked about a couple episodes back? Well, if not, we installed these water sensors that detect water leaks. Anytime it senses any moisture or anything on the actual device, it will immediately just start alarming a really annoying sound and send notifications to your phone to alert you. Sure enough, that happened to us. What'd you do?
Well, it looks like we got a leak. Those Govee water sensors are working, but even more, the washer dryer connections are not working.
Yeah, it says, has detected water leakage.
How do you know it's coming out of the vent?
This is all wet.
Oh, wow. It is. Like, why is there moisture in there?
You know what I could, only thing I could think of? Is I just washed my shoes, and I just washed them only. Yeah. I didn't do a tumble dry. And then I went right to a clean cycle, which also doesn't dry. Like, it's just a lot of water.
Yeah.
So I wonder if...
It got overloaded?
It got overloaded. We might just have to, like... keep an eye on it.
I know that sensor is obnoxious, but it serves its purpose well because it makes you alert and it is able to warn you anywhere in the RV because undoubtedly you're gonna hear it. So that was a lifesaver having those on board. I'm not gonna lie, we actually ended up putting more in the pass-through storage as well because we've had a lot of water leaks go through our pass-through storage and our underbelly. If that's something you want to rely on too, you need that peace of mind, don't worry. We got some links down in the description below. You don't need them, but it's, like I said, peace of mind. I'm glad we got some fresh snow because tomorrow we're actually gonna have fun with our lives and go to the mountain and go do some skiing and snowboarding. I'm really excited about that, but it just brings up a good point. We need to get all of our gear out of storage, and I want to show you guys exactly where we keep everything stored because, hey, the more knowledge you have about cool ideas to store your stuff, the better off you're going to be.
Wow, it is a mess in here right now. What is this? Dexter, it's time for you to clean up, bro. It's messy. Get it cleaned up in here. Hey, do you want to get our ski gear out?
Oh yeah.
Show everyone where all that is.
Oh yeah. Where are the boots?
This is the annoying side of full-time RV life. You're always constantly trying to reorganize. They're in the middle of the pass-through storage, so I gotta rip everything out.
Well, listen, it has been a while since you reorganized the pass-through storage. It's been like a day or two, so it's time.
Ah, this is what the sun feels like. Fresh air. Cabin fever hits on another level. You guys will be happy to know that I did take better care to prepare myself for colder temperatures on this go round outside.
Look, you gotta have warm feet, right? Am I right? Warm feet and sandals.
Yeah, I still got the sweatpants on, but at least I have warm feet now.
La da 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 da. Why are you all the way back there?
Howdy.
Is this pretty normal for the snowfall you guys get?
Last year it wasn't though. Last year we had a big winter last winter.
This is kind of like our first, well, maybe our second time in the area, so you might as well. All right, take care. By no means is this setup ideal. I have not figured out a better way to do this. I mean, these two yellow containers that we got from Costco have our heaviest items, and that's why I keep them in the middle of the RV during travel days. I mean, I wish we could do those Moride slide outs that everyone's talking about, but I don't want to dish money out for it, you know? It's just like one more thing for convenience. Keeps me, you know, young, and I don't know where I'm going with that. See, just turn it, work it around the clear source, and it fits ever so perfectly. So this top one has all the stuff I need the most, like my tools and Bi-Air, stuff like that. See, Bi-Air, Milwaukee Impact. Keep them accessible. And then this one underneath has miscellaneous stuff like ski boots, stuff we don't use very often. Look how organized we are. Going down the mountain should be fun. Take you guys along with. You guys ski or snowboard? Hang on, it's gonna be a fun ride. Are we interrupting?
Oh, hi. All right, we got a mission. Our secret spot, get our skis and snowboards so we don't have to do it tomorrow.
Let's do it.
By the way, if you're curious to all of this, the couch, this setup, everything, I'm not gonna talk about it here because we just did a tour video and we talk about everything in our RV, so you'll wanna go check that out. But what we didn't show you was our secret hiding spot, and I'm about to show you that right now. Okay.
Get in there.
All right. So,
let's go.
All right.
Dude, RV life is so weird. How much stuff you gotta figure out where to put it all. There's our eating tables. Wow. Okay. Been hitting that gym, Nene.
Oh, we got an extra blanket back here.
Okay.
Because, you know, #winter.
Oh, I see them sneaking out. That's crazy. I always forget that they're back there.
You know what's great about going skiing and snowboarding tomorrow?
What?
Is I can vacuum back here.
Finally.
Cat hair? Cat hair. Dexter, thank you. Cat hair and everything.
Just pass them here and I will take them.
I got another set here.
Dexter, hold on to that. Look at that bad boy. Wow. There. Perfect. It's like, can't even tell we've reorganized. See, this is why skiers are annoying, because you carry so much stuff. I'm kidding.
Yeah.
Last one, right?
That's it. That's it. And then you got the boots. They're going to warm up overnight, and we'll be ready to shred the gnar. All right. All done. We'll see you tomorrow. Woo!
Wow. Brushing off the dust here. Well, the snow, I should say.
It's a good run.
It's been a while since we've been out skiing and snowboarding. It's been over a year.
How convenient, too, is that off I-40 is Flagstaff, which is, by the way, a really cool city to visit.
Yeah.
Any time of year. But there's tons of RV parks, and then it's about a 40-minute drive to
here, the mountain. And it's a huge mountain with lots of lifts.
Yeah, and it's almost spring. It's like March 20th today.
We're right in that line. We're on that cusp. But we're glad we're here with you guys. By the way, what's Dexter up to? We left him in your company. You're supposed to be watching him right now.
I knew he was trying to get away from me. I just knew it. As soon as the ski lift started going, I wasn't ready. He just took off. I guess that's how marriage is. The only, when you live together 24/7, we're around each other a lot. The only moment he can get away from me is on the ski lift.
And just like that, all the snow is gone. This has undoubtedly been one of our most favorite trips recently. We got some reprieve of just being off the road, getting some things done, work, catching up on life before we actually hit the road again, because we have a huge journey coming up with you guys and a lot to look forward to. This content is about to get bonkers. These videos forthcoming are gonna be out of this world, basically. You'll see what I mean later on. I am happy to report as well that we did not have any issues with pipes freezing this time. I would say this is a first winter camping for us. No pipes frozen, that's a win. Listen, being on the road full time, I do have something to say. You have to be on your game when it comes to being able to set up campsites every single night. Bouncing around frequently, you need to have a checklist in place and just a way you do things all the time that you can refer back to as a habit so you're not making ultimate mistakes. Check out this video right here because we break down all these mistakes that you could possibly make when setting up a campsite, and it's really funny. We'll see you guys next week.